typical Wi-Fi has a range limit of 100 meters. This is not sufficient when we are talking about, for example, high-speed drones, right? So what we're doing here is we're having the directional antenna that can extend the distance significantly. So the key thing in our test bed is the directional antenna and also the heading control. And these two work together to be able to extend the distance to up to 5 kilometers. So this would be very useful in, for instance, disaster scenarios when the cell tower is down, so there is no communication infrastructure. However, in order to enable information dissemination, the coordination among the rescue teams and the control centers, we have to have a structure available to make all of this happen, and this is what we're trying to provide. When we use directional antennas, there's a key challenge. The key challenge is that when the directions are not aligned, the communication is loud. So when the drones are moving or there's a big wind or things like that, the communication can be easily disrupted. So what we have here is a directional control that can self-align the directions, directions of the antennas to make sure that the antennas on different drones can be aligned to establish the communication link. I have a project from NSF Cyber Physical Systems on the next generation aviation system. So the purpose is how to manage flows to increase the safety and efficiency of the next generation aviation. We cannot rely all the communications through the ground or satellite. So if we can have this technology developed for the drone-to-drone or fly-to-fly communication, we can have better sensing and better coordination and better safety.